wellness. So what does that mean? And how do we achieve it? Well, one thing that is not going to help our physical wellness is if we're sedentary, we're not moving a lot, so you can't get a coach with you and not expect to get some movement again. So please join me in as much as you feel comfortable and able, but we're just going to get some blood flowing, challenge our brains and our bodies. Just stay seated if you'd like. You can stand up if you want to, but just have a little bit of fun before I start my presentation. All right, so we're going to start with some basic shoulder surgery. So I want you to lift your left arm up in the air, and I want you to just try to circles. Try to keep that elbow straight, that wind is coming through your shoulder. 5 inches of pressure. Okay? Now, while you're doing that, I want you to lift your opposite arm up straight ahead, and I want you to outline figure eights while you're doing your circles with your other hand. I probably never did it. Thanks so much. Five inch direction, and then left arm out in front, and then knock out your figure eights. And I want you to close your eyes, one more, and then turn your head to the left. Okay. Because I'm going to try to challenge the coordination more, there's a few points that I have to bring up. So thank you guys for participating. Go ahead and have a seat. All right, so everybody every single day. It's going to help get our blood flowing, it's going to help get our lymph flowing. Sedentary behavior, there's a strong one. There you go. How long does it take you to fall asleep? Now think about that. Once you're asleep, you stay asleep. Do you dream every night? Do you remember your dreams every morning? And when you wake up, do you feel refreshed, energized, or does it take you a while to keep going? So these are all very valuable markers that we should all be tracing and marking and continuing to kind of be aware of, because if we're not getting sleep that's very deep and very restorative and new building, then that's actually going to take away from our physical wellness. So next we're going to talk about self-care. How do you handle your stress? So there's a difference. Maybe not that well, we've seen that response. So the difference between acute stress and chronic stress. So there are definitely times when we need to be in a very sympathetic fight or flight type of state. So if there's a physical threat, if there's deadlines we have to meet, if we're preparing for something big, it's very helpful. But far too often we're stuck in that fight or flight state, and then our stress becomes chronic. And when that happens, it impairs our digestion and it suppresses our immune system. My question is, what type of self-care practices do you implement to get you into more of a relaxed, down-regulated, parasympathetic, rest and digestive type of state? Are you doing any kind of deep breathing daily to stimulate your vagus nerve? Why is it important? Research shows that people that have a stronger vagus nerve response can actually recover a lot faster from illnesses and injuries. Okay, and then lastly, we're going to talk about nutrition. So, pretty simple. Are we eating whole natural foods, or are we on that sad diet? You know what sad diet is? Standard American diet. That's what I'm saying. That's it. Your sugar, refined carbs, and your processed foods. So, if you're traveling here, so Linus Pauling is a two-time Nobel Prize winner, and he said that you can trace every ailment, sickness, and disease to a micronutrient deficiency. So it's that simple. When we give ourselves and we give our bodies the raw materials that it needs from real food, it's got the power to heal from chronic disease. It's got the power to actually prevent chronic disease, despite our family history. And that's called epigenetics. So my question to you is, are you getting your essential fatty acids, your essential amino acids? Are you getting your carbs, your proteins, your fats? Are you eating real food that builds up that beneficial bacteria in your gut microbiome? It helps with your production of your serotonin, your dopamine, it boosts your metabolism, and it also boosts your immune system. So why do I bring all these things up? because we have to have a very holistic approach when it comes to physical illness. Because there isn't just one thing that's going to get us there. And when we have a very strong foundation in a number of different areas, then it helps us achieve that physical wellness. So I'd like to introduce Dr. Vianei Jex, and she's going to be speaking about emotional and psychological wellness. Thank you, guys.